Hey, what's up, guys? Jesse here from Metroline Direct. I'm really excited to tell you guys that we've switched over to AnyDesk for our remote connections, so now we can help people even better than before. We've really found it to be more consistent and faster than what we've been using in the past. So we're really excited about that. So in this video, I'm going to show you what it looks like from the customer side to have a technician connect to your computer. And this is going to be a one-time connection. In the next video, we're going to show what it looks like for a user to allow someone to connect unattended. Now, I wish I didn't have to say this, but AnyDesk is like any remote software. It can be used by hackers to take over your computer. Of course, there are safeguards in place, but please make sure you're working with someone you trust and don't accept any connections from someone you're not expecting. Hey, if you like this video, do me a favor and let us know by tapping the like button. And if you want to see more videos, tap the subscribe button and don't forget to tap the notification bell. So the first thing you're going to do is go to anydesk.com and this website will load and it will have a green download button. Click on that and this window should open up and the file should start to automatically download. Depending on if you have the Chrome web browser, the file should show up at the bottom. Or if you have Firefox, it will show up at the top right corner. You'll have to click the arrow button to see your download. So in my case, I'm using Chrome, so it shows up on the bottom left corner here. If you don't see the file downloading, you can try clicking on in the middle where it says Download Now, and then it will try to download it in a different way. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this. And pretty quickly, this window should pop up. On the upper left-hand side, it will say This Desk, and it will give you a number underneath that. This is the number that you need to give to the technician in order for the technician to be able to connect. So if you're not seeing this, it's possible that the AnyDesk app might be blocked in your computer firewall or in your company firewall. So I'm going to go ahead and connect on my end. And this window will pop up. These are the permissions that you can give the technician. The noticeable one for me would be this one right here. It says allow to take control. If you don't have this one clicked, like if you click it here to unselect it, then the technician would be able to connect but not be able to click the mouse or type something with the keyboard. So if your technician is going to be helping you program something, you might want to leave that selected. And then you can click on this icon to turn off the file manager permission. And what that allows you to do is to share files back and forth between the technician and you, or to not share them if you turn this off. So let's say you have a configuration file that you want to send to the technician, or the technician's going to be sending you a professionally recorded greeting. You want to have that turned on in those situations. But let's say you have that turned off, and then later on you change your mind and you decide you want to turn that back on. You can always click on the AnyDesk icon at the bottom and click on that icon to turn the feature back on. And this icon allows the technician to basically black out the screen so that the customer doesn't see what's on the screen. It's turned off by default, and I don't ask people to turn on this feature. Personally, I wouldn't want someone connecting to my computer and blacking out the screen, but I do think it's a good feature in certain situations. Okay, so let's go ahead and click on the Accept button. And this will allow the technician to connect. So if I don't click on this accept button, then the technician can't accept. So that's a big safeguard there because as the user of a computer, you are in control of who connects to your system. One more thing you probably didn't see there is the user account control window will pop up and it will ask you if you want to allow the AnyDesk app to make changes to your computer. You'll need to click on yes in order for that to allow the connection. And so pretty quickly I can start making changes on the customer's phone system or whatever I need to do on here. And at any time, if I want to disconnect the session, I can go back to the AnyDesk icon in the taskbar and I can click the disconnect button. And that ends the session right there. In fact, AnyDesk doesn't even install itself. So once you click on end session, AnyDesk is removed from your computer. Stay tuned for my next video where I show how to set up an unattended session with AnyDesk. And don't forget if you liked the video, click the like button and subscribe. Thanks for watching.